Welcome to the Believer's Walk of Faith, empowering believers through teaching, preaching, and demonstration of the uncompromised Word of God to fulfill their highest calling and change this world through Jesus Christ, to glorify God in all we do, to train up and send out believers, to cover the whole earth with the knowledge of the Lord. Welcome to the Believer's Walk of Faith.
Hello, I'm Bill Winston, and welcome to another program. The program that you're watching is called The Believer's Walk of Faith, where we walk by faith and not by sight. Well, we have another exciting teaching. We're teaching on this subject, the blessing of Abraham. Praise God. Oh, this is exciting. Now, the first thing that we find out is that the blessing of Abraham is a material blessing. Now, we got the spiritual blessing through Jesus, because that's where we could cast out demons and all the spiritual authority that we have. But the material blessing came through Abraham, and the Bible calls him Abraham our father, meaning that he was a father of the faithful, that those who believe are included in the family of Abraham. So now, when we're talking about having blessing and material blessing, Proverbs 22 and verse 7 says that the rich rule over the poor and the borrower is servant to the lender. So here's what I want you to remember. It is impossible to rule in this human system without financial empowerment. So if God wants you to be the head and not the tail, the lender and not the borrower, you're going to have some finances. You're going to have the material wealth of the earth in your hand to manage. So what we want to do is find out how to make this happen. Get your Bibles and pencils and papers ready. It's going to be a powerful teaching today. Let's go into it. It's called The Blessing of Abraham.
God has redeemed you from poverty. Now, you can be poor if you want to be. You got what I'm saying? God has made you a free moral agent, and you are free in His eyes, and you decide. You decide what you are going to settle for in life. You decide what level you're going to be content with. You decide how high you want to climb, how rich you want to be, how big you want your business to go. You decide what kind of lifestyle gives you fulfillment. You decide how long you want to live, how much respect you want to get, and what goals you want to reach. You decide that. Now, I'm saying that God will let you be poor if you want to be poor. And the reason why is because He'll free, and He won't make you be rich. So in this, if you don't know how to walk in line with God's plan, then the outcome is that you're going to walk in the curse of poverty. A lot of times we're struggling to be rich, and you don't have to struggle to be rich. That is a deception. You do not have to struggle to be rich. Did Abraham struggle when he went down there to Egypt? He lied about the fact that he didn't tell Pharaoh that was his wife. He told him it was his sister. And then he came out of there, and God made him how rich? Very rich. No struggle. I'm telling you, folks, the deception is that you got to work for it. You are working, but you're not working for a living. You ain't working for an inheritance. Inheritance is yours because somebody gave it to you. Now, I want you to see something here. Now, so let's deal first, because people talk about, well, that's not the will of God that everybody be rich. Well, if you're poor, I'm talking about in the body of Christ now. I'm not talking about people in the world. You're poor because you're ignorant of God's covenant or how to appropriate what's available for you in your life. Now, listen, I'm not talking down to you. I'm telling you the truth. Because we've had a victim mentality saying, I'm poor because I'm black. Once you come into the kingdom, that goes away. Because you've been redeemed. Some folks say, I'm poor because I'm Spanish. I'm poor because I came from across the tracks. And I told people, you can be born on the tracks. But if you're in the kingdom of God, brother, you've been redeemed from the curse of poverty. I'm poor because of the nation I'm living in. I live in Africa. I live in Haiti. It doesn't make any difference. If the blessing of Abraham has come on you, God will prosper you on the top of a mountain. Now, my point is that some people, I'm poor. Well, this is happening to me because the Democrats are in. This is happening to me because the Republicans. Doesn't make any difference. Doesn't make any difference. Come on back over to Joshua chapter 1. Doesn't make any difference. See, God is not sending us here to take sides. He's sending us here to take over. And whatever side it is, don't make no difference with me. It won't be able to stop me. God, it doesn't make any difference. Now, I want the righteous in authority, because when the righteous in authority, the people can rejoice. But the devil can't stop me. See, that's deception, and the enemy telling you because this or that, because such and such in the office is over, then you stop. You're not stopped. What's stopping you is your ignorance. And I'm going to tell you how to get out of it if you'll sit here and take it. Look what it said in the book of Joshua. Book of Joshua chapter 1 and verse 5. And there shall not any man be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, I'm going to be with you. I will not fail you. Come on. Or forsake you. We've come into a blaming generation, and that's a spirit, and it'll try to come on you, and the next thing you know is it'll try to spread to you, to your household, and cause you not to prosper. Now, I'm telling you right now, so don't let anybody come in and tell you. Now, there's a reason for the prosperity. That's the key, because there's an integrity with God. And what has happened is people many times don't want to hear this, especially folks who really need it, because their minds have been so brainwashed until sometimes it's just almost frustrating. You're trying to teach them and tell them something because, you know, this is not hard, folks. This is not rocket science. This is, you can get this anytime. It says this. Now, listen to what I'm saying. The misunderstanding. Where does the misunderstanding come from? One of the main things that has happened, again, has been Satan, because he wanted to deceive. And many times what he'll do is he'll put people in your path that will teach you and teach you something out of their own spirit versus out of the Spirit of God. And when they came back from spying out Canaan, they had two different reports. Now, how could you see the same thing I saw and you have something different? So you know something's wrong with it. Now, my point is, they're looking in the same Bible I'm looking at, and the next thing they tell you is you're not supposed to be rich. And the Bible just said, Jesus, who was rich, became poor, that you through his poverty might be rich. And they're going to look at the same scripture I'm looking at and then take a poverty vow. Now, you look at this. I'm going to show you where the enemy has been getting away with this. Let's go over here to Romans, please, and Romans chapter 10. Now, you better hear what I'm saying, because God will allow you to be sick. God will allow you to be broke. Let me ask you a question. When Adam was in the garden, didn't God tell him don't eat of the tree?
Yes.
Yep. Did he eat of it?
Yes.
Did God come in there and knock the fruit out of his hand? Nope. He allowed him to eat of the tree and the whole humanity to fall. He will allow you to be sick. He will allow you to be broke. And he'll allow you to do it for as long as you're in the earth. And if you don't know how to appropriate this, the curse will come in. The devil is out there to keep you in bondage. That's his whole thing. He wants to keep you enslaved. Now, all I got to do is teach you and you follow it. That's all you got to do. And I didn't say he gonna bless you and you gonna have all of this if you got a Harvard degree. I got nothing against Harvard University, but I'm gonna tell you something. That is not what's gonna put you on top. What's going to put you on top is not your degree, but your revelation. Don't ever forget that. You see, it's going to make some folk mad because they done paid all this money for all that, and nothing wrong with that. But if they got all of that without all of this, then they ain't going nowhere. The devil still got control of them. See, I'm telling you, it's going to be tough. That's why he said that a lot of people that are high up and so forth, they ain't going to want to hear this. They ain't going to want to hear it. But watch what's going to happen. Watch what's going to happen. Joseph was raised up out of prison to prime minister with no resume. What raised him up? What raised him up? Revelation raised him up. Revelation will raise you up. Whoever's got revelation goes to the top. Whoever's got revelation gonna lead the pack. Whoever's got revelation gonna get the goods. Whoever's got revelation, I'm telling you, see the enemy, glory to God. Are y'all still here with me? Proverbs chapter 22 and Romans chapter 5. All right, look at Romans chapter 5 first, verse 17. For by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one Jesus Christ. Now, God has a plan for us to take over this earth. He has a plan for us as believers to rule this earth. That's God's plan. If that's not your plan, you better line up with God's plan. All right, now, look over Proverbs chapter 22. Look what it said in verse 7. The rich rules over the who? Poor. And the borrower is servant to the who? The lender. So it tells me that it's impossible for you to rule in this human system without financial empowerment. I'll say it again. It's impossible for you to rule in this financial system without financial empowerment. You must have the money. You cannot rule in this system, and you are supposed to rule. Now, I just told you that the rich rule over the poor. Why do you think the ungodly want the rich? I mean, want the money. Why do you think Satan wants the ungodly with the money? Because he wants them to rule over you. Are you following what I'm saying? All right, now, the enemy tries to set up these boundaries to keep you out, political, economic, and religious. And religious boundaries, he'll try to get you to take a poverty vow or think that people taking a poverty vow because they're in leadership, elite leadership, or they are agreeing with God. And that's a lie. Poverty is a curse any way you look at it. Turn to Ecclesiastes chapter, after Proverbs, Ecclesiastes chapter 9, please. See, distorted images. He gave you an image that Abraham was out there just taking care of little sheep, you know, and so forth. And it's not true. He had about 2,000 employees. And taking out sheep, he only had to count it. And I'm talking about the same thing as opposed to you. He was extremely rich. And then when you went down there, and Isaac, he sent Eleazar up there to get a wife for Isaac, and went up there to Laban's house, and he went up there, and here Rebekah met him out there, and he put a bracelet, you know, the thing said bracelet, so people think of a bracelet, a little something, you know, on your wrist. Aim the bracelet. The bracelet fitted the whole arm. It was gold. It was shekels of gold. It says an earring, and they look at earrings. Look at the little tinky earring. That wasn't earring. Look at the thing. Look at my book, Bible has a center column reference in it. It says headpiece. It was a crown. So if you don't have knowledge, as nobody's taught you, who's supposed to be teaching you, then you'll think you got a little sheep. Now that's not true, folks. I'm not talking about $50,000 in the bank. That ain't gonna do it. Have you seen what's going on in the world of poverty today? Those God assigned you to feed one of those nations over there. Folks, there shouldn't be any problem for us. But if we don't let the blessing of Abraham come on us, we can't do those things. That's what Joseph did. He fed the world. All right, let me just finish this. Look what it says here in Ecclesiastes chapter 10, chapter 9, and verse 16. Then said I, wisdom is better than strength. Nevertheless, the poor man's wisdom is despised, and the word, his words, are not heard. Now, let me read it in another translation. Whatever a poor man says will not be appreciated. So you know you can't be poor. Because if you're going to be poor, ain't nobody going to want to hear what you got to say. The only thing I do is look at your life. They say, well, how are you going to tell somebody something? Now, are you with me? All right, now, let me just wrap this up today. Integrity. Say integrity, somebody. Integrity. One man said it like this. The true measure of a man is not determined by what he does before men, but what he does when no one will ever know what he did. I'll try that again. The true measure of a man is not determined by what he does before men, but what he does when no one will ever know what he did. Integrity. Now, what am I saying? Lack of financial integrity makes access into the promised land impossible. Lack of financial integrity makes access into the promised land impossible. Now, I'm talking about defrauding people. I'm talking about bribing folks. I'm talking about embezzlement and robbing folks and robbing Caesar. You got to pay your taxes. Now, there's some legitimate ways that you can reduce your taxes, but you better get legitimate. Because if you robbing something, it ain't gonna work. Because God's not gonna honor that. I tell some of the pastors sometimes, I said, the reason why some of y'all ain't getting blessed because you stealing money from the IRS. I said, you stealing from the federal government. What you need to do is you need to find legitimate ways that you can reduce your taxes and so forth and do that. But I'm talking, and folks in the church, you know, you in your kitchen doing hair, getting money every night and not paying no taxes. I'm just telling you right now, you think you're gonna get into the promised land? Won't happen. Won't happen. You know that money's supposed to be additional income. But you think that you're going to get in there because you're pulling something on somebody. But you can't, because God is the judge. He's the one that's taking you into the promised land, not a man. The devil will love. He don't mind if you cheat on your income tax when you ain't saved. But once you get saved, he's going to tell on you. Because he got this, that's his system. Y'all look, y'all done got serious now, boy. Y'all looking at me like I don't know what. You better get right. Look at Proverbs chapter 28. Are y'all glad you came here today? See, I'm going to teach you the whole counsel of God. I'm not going to be up here with some get-rich-quick scheme because it ain't in there. It ain't in the Bible. It's a blessing of Abraham I'm talking about. And you got to walk with integrity. That means what you doing when ain't nobody looking. Because God sees your every move. And he is your judge, not a man. Look at Proverbs chapter 28. Have you got it? Look what it says over here in verse 8. He that by usury and unjust gain increases his substance, he's going to gather it all right, but he's going to gather it for those who have pity on the poor. You got what I'm saying? So that's what I'm talking about right there. I'm talking about people who use other people, people who are cheating, people so forth and so on. Well, I just... Gary, you know, I need to pay this bill, but I see this new dress. I need to get that. Well, see, you ain't going to get into the promised land. You know you need to pay that bill. I mean, the people, you owe the people. Why are you going to not pay them and try to and get something that you could do without? See, I was getting amens until I started all of this. That car note is due, and you don't need to run out there and go on another vacation when that car note's due like that. And this teaching some of y'all have never had in your life. But this is a part of the redeemed from poverty. Because some of y'all are still staying in it because you're violating the law of integrity. And you cannot do that. Now, you start dealing forthright with people. Now, let me just finish by telling you this. This is what the devil does. The enemy tries to get, and that goes for the tithe, by the way. I didn't hit on that, but I'll just try to cover that next time and wrap this whole redeemed from poverty up. But the tithe, see, when you rob the tithe,
then you're blocking the door to the promised land. That you can't get in it without the tithe. So anyway, the enemy enslaves, but God empowers. Now, I'll say that again. The enemy enslaves, but God empowers. Are you following what I'm saying? Now, here's what I mean. Somebody using someone else to get over on. I'm going to use them as a stepping stone to where I want to get. That's the devil. Now, he doesn't want to enslave two people. He wants to enslave the whole world. He's trying to use them to step up to where he wants to get. God is different. He empowers us. So the moment you get born again, he says to you, come on up here and sit up here with me. And whatever I got, you can share this. And if there's any knowledge I got, you can have that too. See, he's not trying to keep you down and keep him up. And that's where some people are. Because they don't feel comfortable if somebody else is rising. Remember, Satan wants to keep you down. Jesus wants to bring you up. My job is to teach you exactly what I know. I don't have no jealousy about it. I don't care if you try to outrun me. Now, you have to go pretty good to do it. But I don't care if you outrun me on some of your faith and some of your items and so forth. That's fine. But let me tell you, it doesn't bother me at all. What gives me joy is when one of the saints come and give me a testimony that what I taught worked.